And after a nine-month-long wait and legal hurdles, aviation regulator DGCA has granted flying license to the new airline Air Asia India. Air Asia India, the joint venture between Malaysia's Air Asia and Tata Group, has got license to start their operations in India. Air Asia India Private Limited will be country's seventh airline and aims to start flying anywhere between 1 to 3 months from now.
It seems that aviation sector is all set to fly high. India's seventh airline was officially born on Wednesday as Air Asia India's year-long wait got over after DGCA gave green signal to the carrier. Air Asia, which is a budget airline set up by one of Asia's biggest low-cost carriers, Air Asia, and India's Tata Group, has won approval for operations. The stakes will be Air Asia 49%, Tata Sons 30%, and Arun Bhatia of Telestra Trade Place 21%. The joint venture plans to operate from Chennai. It will focus on providing domestic connectivity to Tier 2 and Tier 3 cities. Air Asia, through its operations based in Thailand and Malaysia, flies to Indian cities Chennai, Bangalore, Kochi, Tiruchirappalli and Kolkata from several destinations in the ASEAN region. It will be the first airline with foreign investment to operate in India. India opened up its aviation market to foreign investment in 2012 in an attempt to boost growth in the sector and the overall economy. Indian airlines have been mired in losses because of rising fuel costs as well as intense price competition. Only one of India's six main carriers, IndiGo, has been making profits. India has seen a surge in demand for air travel in recent years, making it one of the faster growing aviation markets in the region. However, in an attempt to capture a bigger share of the growing market, airlines have been slashing their fares to attract more customers. Air Asia India has said it will offer one of the lowest fares to lure travelers and will rapidly expand its fleet by adding 10 Airbus A320 planes a year. High fuel prices, taxes and fees have squeezed existing Indian airlines. The sector lost a combined $1.3 billion in the financial years to March. According to sources, Air Asia will look to price their tickets nearly 35% lower than the average fares in the market currently. Now, with the competition increasing in the aviation market, it remains to be seen how Air Asia will plan its strategy.